Hello everyone, now let us discuss about plasma kinins, bradykinin and caladin. So now what are plasma kinins? Plasma kinins are polypeptides split off from a plasma globulin kininogen by the action of specific enzymes which are called kallikreins. So the plasma kinins are generated by proteolytic reactions and they are triggered by tissue injury, inflammation and allergic reactions. There are mainly two plasma kinins. The first one is bradykinin and the next one is caladin. Coming to kininogens. Kininogens are alpha 2 globulins present in plasma which also contain inactive kininogenase which is prekallikrein. They are alpha globulins which are present in the plasma, and kininogens are mainly of two types, high molecular weight kininogens and low molecular weight kininogens. The high molecular weight kininogens are cleaved by both tissue and plasma kallikrein and they yield bradykinin and caladin. Whereas low molecular weight kininogens, they are cleaved by only tissue kallikrein and they yield caladin. Coming to kallikreins, these are the specific enzymes. A number of serine proteases will generate kinins, but two highly specific proteases that release bradykinin and caladin are termed as kallikreins. And the kallikreins are normally present in their inactive zymogen forms, and thus physiologically only small amounts of kinins are generated. There are mainly two types of kallikreins. The first one is plasma kallikrein and the next one is tissue kallikrein. The plasma kallikrein, it acts on high molecular weight kininogens to yield bradykinin, whereas tissue kallikrein, it acts on both high molecular weight and low molecular weight kininogens to yield caladin. Now coming to the synthesis and metabolism of kinins, we all know that the kininogens are alpha globulins which are present in plasma. They also contain inactive kininogenase which is called prekallikrein. This prekallikrein is activated by Hagemann's factor, which is nothing but factor 12. This Hagemann's factor in turn is activated by tissue injury and contact with surface having negative charge, for example collagen, basement membrane, bacterial liposaccharides, urate crystals, etc. So, and additionally plasmin, it facilitates the contact activation of Hagemann's factor. So the bradykinin is generated from high molecular weight kininogens by the action of plasma kallikrein. Trypsin and proteolytic enzymes in snake and wasp venoms can also synthesize kinins. So initially the bradykinin is synthesized from high molecular weight kininogen by the action of plasma kallikrein, and it usually does not cross the capillaries, whereas caladin, it is produced from both high molecular weight and low molecular weight kininogens by the action of tissue kallikrein. And additionally, the caladin can be converted to bradykinin. Bradykinin can also be generated from caladin on the removal of lysine residue by an aminopeptidase. So these are the overall synthesis of bradykinin and caladin. And the plasma and tissues, they also contain kininogenase inhibitory factors like C1 esterase inhibitor. Now, coming to metabolism. Coming to the metabolism of kinins, they are rapidly degraded primarily in lungs, and the plasma T-half is usually less than a minute. And the principal degrading enzyme is kininase 2. The principal degrading enzyme of kinins is kininase 2, which is also called as angiotensin 2 converting enzyme, ACE. which splits two amino acids from the carboxy terminal of the peptide chain. And another enzyme, which is carboxypeptidase, is kininase 1. It removes only one amino acid, producing selective beta 1 receptor agonist metabolites, desaginin calidin and desaginin bradykinin. Whenever kininase 2, it acts on bradykinin and calidin and it inactivates them. Whereas kininase 1, when it acts on bradykinin, it produces desaginin bradykinin, and kininase 1, when acts on calidin, it produces desaginin calidin. These are the metabolites and they have selective B1 receptor agonist nature. Now coming to the metabolism, 80 to 90% of kinins may be destroyed in single passage through the pulmonary vascular bed. As we have discussed earlier, they are rapidly degraded primarily in the lungs. Pulmonary vascular bed by enzymes present on the large endothelial surface of the lung. The principal catabolizing enzyme in the lungs and other vascular beds is kininase 2 or angiotensin converting enzyme. It is a membrane anchored peptidase on the surface of endothelial cells. And the removal of C-terminal dipeptide. The removal of C-terminal dipeptide by ACE, and additional to ACE, another enzyme can also inactivate kinins, that is neutral endopeptidase, which is also called as neprilysin. So removal of C-terminal dipeptide by ACE or neutral endopeptidase inactivates the kinin. Coming to the action of other enzymes on kinins. Apart from kininase 2 or ACE, some other enzymes, they also act on kinins. The first one is carboxypeptidase N, which is also called as lysine carboxypeptidase, and this is kininase 1. The action of kininase 1 is to release the C-terminal arginine residue, producing desarginine metabolites, which are potent B1 receptor agonists. The next enzyme is carboxypeptidase M. Carboxypeptidase N is kininase 1. The carboxypeptidase M is usually 3-fold faster than kininase 1 and it cleaves the C-terminal arginine residue of bradykinin. The next enzyme is aminopeptidase. So it cleaves the N-terminal lysine residue of calidin and it converts that to bradykinin. Coming to the receptors of kinins. The receptors of kinins are of two types, B1 and B2. B1 is mostly induced by inflammation, whereas B2 performs most non-inflamed actions. Coming to agonist, the desarginin metabolites are selective agonists for B1, whereas bradykinin and calidin are selective agonists for B2. And they mediate the principal actions such as contraction of intestine, uterus and airway, vasodilation and increased permeability, and also associated in acute pain. These are some of the actions of B2 receptor. Coming to B1 receptors and B2 receptors. The B1 receptors, they are minimally expressed in normal tissue but are induced by inflammation, and they co-localize with kininase 1 enzyme, so that desarginin and kinins are produced at the same site. And they are coupled with GQ or GI proteins, and they cause constriction of veins, large vessels, enhanced prostaglandin synthesis, leukocyte recruitment, generation of inducible nitric oxide synthase, and also chronic pain in inflamed tissues. These are some of the actions that are mediated by B1 receptors. Now coming to B2 receptors, they are coupled to GQ and GI proteins which utilize phospholipase C or IP3-DAG intracellular calcium mobilization transducer mechanism. And here the endothelial nitric oxide synthase is activated, causing vasodilation, and certain actions such as bronchoconstriction, renal vasodilation, activation of pain nerve endings appear to be mediated by activation of phospholipase A and generation of prostaglandin at local site. And the activated GQ protein mediates the generation of pro-inflammatory mediators. Now coming to the role or action of plasma kinins. They mainly act on blood vessels, smooth muscle, neurons and kidneys. Now coming to the role of kinins in blood vessels. The kinins are more potent vasodilators. Kinins are more potent vasodilators than acetylcholine and histamine. And the dilation is mediated through endothelial nitric oxide and PGI2 generation. And it involves mainly arterioles. Kinins, they cause dilation of arterioles. In contrast, large arteries, most veins and vessels with damaged endothelium are constricted by direct action of kinins on smooth muscle. They can release histamine and other mediators from the mast cells. Injected IV kinins, they cause flushing, throbbing, headache and fall in BP. They markedly increase the capillary permeability due to separation of endothelial cells. And exudation and inflammation may occur if they are injected to a tissue. Intradermal injection, it usually produces veal and flare similar to that of histamine. And the kinins, they have no direct action on heart, but the reflex stimulation occurs due to fallen BP. These are some of the actions of kinins on blood vessels. Now coming to the role of kinins in smooth muscle and kidney. The kinins, they induce contraction of intestine, which is characteristically slow. They cause marked bronchoconstriction in guinea pigs and in asthmatic patients. The overall actions of kinins on smooth muscles are contraction of intestine, uterus and airway. Coming to the role in kidney. In kidney, the kinins, they increase renal blood flow and increase salt and water excretion. The bradykinin, it specifically causes natriuresis by inhibiting sodium reabsorption at the cortical collecting duct. And one more important point is the diuretic effect of furosemide is reduced by kinin B2 receptor antagonists. The diuretic effect of furosemide is reduced by B2 receptor antagonists, indicating participation of locally generated kinins in this response. Coming to the role of kinins in neurons, the kinins, they strongly stimulate nociceptive efferents and produce a burning sensation. The applied to blister base, whenever kinins are applied to blister base or injected intraperitoneally or in the brachial artery, bradykinins produce intense and transient pain and they are employed in analgesic testing. Bradykinins, they can produce intense and transient, temporary, transient pain and they are employed in analgesic testing. The kinins, they release catecholamines from the adrenal medulla and injected directly to brain, they may produce enhanced sympathetic discharge and they even increase the permeability of blood-brain barrier. Coming to the pathophysiological roles of kinins, they are mainly involved in mediation of inflammation, mediation of pain, functional hyperemia, hereditary angioedema, cardioprotective action. They are also involved in asthma and allergic rhinitis and they have a role in adjustment of fetal to neonatal circulation. Coming to the mediation of inflammation by kinins. Usually, kinins increase permeability in microcirculation by acting on small venules to cause disruption of interendothelial junctions. And this together with an increased hydrostatic pressure causes edema. This is the first effect of kinins. They increase the permeability in microcirculation. This together with increased hydrostatic pressure causes edema. Edema coupled with stimulation of nerve endings results in veal and flare response to intradermal injections. And the B1 receptor on the inflammatory cells, such as which are macrophages, can also elicit production of inflammatory mediators like interleukin-1 and tumor necrosis factor alpha. The kinin levels are increased in number of chronic inflammatory diseases, and they may be significant in gout, disseminated intravascular coagulation, inflammatory bowel disease, rheumatoid arthritis, and asthma. And their receptors are associated with neuropathic pain in diabetes, autoimmune encephalomyelitis, and Alzheimer's disease. Additionally, they contribute to skeletal changes in chronic inflammatory states by stimulating bone resorption. These are some of the effects of kinins on inflammation. Coming to mediation of pain, kinins are powerful analgesic agents that cause an intense burning pain when applied to exposed base of blister. The bradykinin, it excites primary sensory neurons and provokes the release of neuropeptides such as substance P, neurokinin A, calcitonin gene-related peptide, etc. And B2 receptors, they generally mediate acute bradykinin analgesia. This is an important point. The B2 receptors, they generally mediate acute bradykinin analgesia, whereas the pain of chronic inflammation involves increased numbers and activation of B1 receptors. B1 receptors are involved in chronic inflammation pain, whereas B2 receptors, they generally mediate acute bradykinin analgesia, which is intense and transient. Coming to the role of kinins in asthma and allergic rhinitis. Kinins have been involved in allergic airway disorders like asthma and rhinitis. Inhalation of kinins causes bronchospasm mimicking an asthma attack in asthmatic patient, but this does not occur in normal individuals. This bradykinin-induced bronchoconstriction is blocked by anticholinergics, but not by conventional antihistamines or cyclooxygenase inhibitors. And similarly, a nasal challenge with bradykinin is followed by sneezing and granular secretions in patients with allergic rhinitis, but not in normal individuals or those with non-allergic, non-infectious perineal rhinitis. Coming to hereditary angioedema. This is a rare hereditary disorder, and it is due to quantitative or functional deficiency of C1 esterase inhibitor, which is most important natural kininogenesis inhibitor. As a result, the plasma bradykinin levels rise, manifesting in unpredictable episodes of swelling of lips, tongue, face, respiratory and gastrointestinal tract, hands and feet, etc. So, inhibitors of kinin production and B2 receptor antagonists, they afford symptomatic relief in angioedema. Inhibitors of kinin production and B2 receptor antagonists, they afford symptomatic relief in hereditary angioedema. Coming to the first case, kallikrein inhibitors. These are the inhibitors of kinin production. Example of drug is Ecallantide. It is a synthetic plasma kallikrein inhibitor. It is approved for treatment of acute attacks of hereditary angioedema in patients 12 years or older, and it is administered by healthcare professional with appropriate medical support to manage the possible anaphylaxis. And subcutaneously, a total dose of 30 mg divided in 3 10 mg injections of 1 ml each is given. An additional dose of 30 mg may be administered within 24-hour period if the attack persists. Coming to the side effects, they are headache, nausea, fever, diarrhea, injection site reactions, and nasopharyngitis. Anaphylaxis has been reported in 4% patients within 1 hour after dosing. Now, coming to the second drug, they are kinin receptor antagonist, specifically B2 receptor antagonist, icatibant. Icatibant, it is a synthetic decapeptide, selective B2 receptor antagonist that has been approved in EU, UK and USA for the treatment of acute episodes of swelling in patients with more than 18 years of age with hereditary angioedema. And the duration of action is up to 6 hours after subcutaneous injection. It effectively reverses the swelling and other symptoms of angioedema. The side effects, the most common side effect is reaction at injection site. And additionally, fever, elevated transaminase, headache, rash, dizziness and nausea are less common. Coming to the dosing, 30 mg in 3 ml of solution as subcutaneous injection is given. Additional doses may be administered at an interval of 6 hours each if the response is inadequate or symptoms reoccur. And not more than 3 doses should be given within 24-hour period. And the utility of icatibant in treating drug-induced angioedema, burns, pancreatitis and other conditions involving kinins is being explored. And a recent controlled trial has been reported icatibant injected subcutaneously to be more effective in resolving ACE inhibitor-induced angioedema than the standard therapy with IV prednisolone and an antihistamine. Coming to the next action of kinins, it is cardioprotective action. Kinins appear to play no significant role in regulation of normal BP. They serve to oppose, but usually kinins appear to play no significant role in the regulation of normal BP, but they serve to oppose the overactive renin angiotensin system and exert anti-proliferative influence on cardiac and vascular muscles in hypertensive states. And urinary kallikrein concentrations are decreased in individuals with high blood pressure. And the kallikrein kinin system is usually cardioprotective, and many of the beneficial effects of ACE inhibitors on heart function are attributable to enhancement of bradykinin effects, such as their anti-proliferative activity and the ability to increase the tissue glucose uptake. Additionally, bradykinin contributes to beneficial effect of preconditioning to protect the heart against ischemia and reperfusion injury. Bradykinin also stimulates tissue plasminogen activator release from the vascular endothelium and may contribute to the endogenous defense against some cardiovascular events such as myocardial infarction and stroke. Coming to the other effects of kinins. The kinins, they cause the closure of ductus arteriosus, dilation of fetal pulmonary artery and constriction of umbilical vessels. Thus, they may be involved in adjusting from fetal to neonatal circulation. The next one is functional hyperemia in glands during secretion, and they also lead to regulation of microcirculation, especially in kidneys, that is mediated by kinins. Kinins, they affect the CNS, disrupting the blood-brain barrier and allowing increased CNS penetration. They also play a major role in development of angioedema. They also appear to be involved in shock, ACE inhibitor-induced cough, acute pancreatitis, fluid secretion in diarrhea and certain immunological conditions. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for further videos on pharmacology and other related pharmaceutical sciences.